Hi, my name is Anne Surridge. I'm a technical development manager here at Fargro, and welcome to the first in our series of videos on the new biofungicide Taegro. So what will we be looking at over these series of videos? Well, in this first video, we'll be joined later by Daniel Lightfoot from Syngenta, who is the business manager for the UK and Ireland. He'll be looking a bit about how Syngenta work in the UK within horticulture. We'll then be joined later on by Stuart Mills, who will discuss the diseases that are controlled by Taegro. In video two, I'll look specifically at Taegro, the product itself. So what's in it, how it works, the mode of action, as well as some technical details on the product. And then in video three, I'll be joined by Dr. Joshua Bernstone, where we'll discuss Taegro, but also more broadly the biopesticide industry developments and what growers in the UK can expect in the coming years. So without further delay, I'll hand over to Dan to give you an introduction to Syngenta.
Well, thanks, Ank. Thanks for giving me a bit of time at the beginning of your presentation. And I just wanted to say a few words about Taegro and how Syngenta supports horticultural growers. I've been running the Syngenta business for about 6 years now. My name's Daniel Lightfoot. I'm the UK business manager, and I'm supported by a really great team. Glenn Kirby, who's UK technical manager, Elizabeth Green, marketing, Marcel, European technical, Ashley, who's in charge of digital development, and Spence, who's part of the communications team. So we've got a really good team supporting horticulture in the UK. We set it up 4 or 5 years ago, and it's really focused around making sure that we can support growers in the field with new technology Syngenta's bringing forward. And I just wanted to say a few bits about what we've been trying to do over the past few years. So as well as bringing new products, and you can see some of them here at the bottom of the screen, it's also about making sure that there's that kind of wraparound support for growers who are out there working every day using Syngenta products. So we built a new website. So you can see that at syngentaornamentals.co.uk. And it's very much got all of the products on there in terms of MSDS and labels, which I know people like. There's even a quick label finder if you really want to just quickly find what some information from a label. But there's a lot more things around it, and we tried to really build those in to make sure that you had all of the support that you need. There's an advisory blog, so please sign up, subscribe to that. It just talks about the issues of the day, disease issues, product issues, best practice, and it's a really great tool that we'd kind of use to communicate to growers to just give the best advice that we've got and some information we think will be really, really useful. So please, if you get a chance, you can subscribe. It says here, if you want to know when a new blog's landed, just click on subscribe on the website, and then you'll get the automatic emails to give you the information. So it's a great resource. Well, we also developed the advice hub, and in there's a whole kind of a plethora of different things. But for me, art of application, this thing we called art of application, it's about application advice, really, where we put loads of information, videos, how-tos, calculators, loads of things in there about how to get the best out of your applications. I think the products, you know, are very technical and they're not cheap. And so therefore, you want to get the best out of them. And for me, what's really, really important is that you make sure that you get the most out of the application. You get it to be as efficacious as you possibly can. So we put loads of information around application advice to make sure that the growers get all the support they need, getting the best out of the products that you bought from Syngenta. But I think fundamentally, why are we going into biologicals and why have we launched Taegro? I think I just wanted to touch on that. You can see here like the integrated pest management triangle, reminds me a bit of the fire triangle. And it really has to be done from a bottom up strategy. And that's not where Syngenta works at the bottom there, but it's definitely what we advise. And so I think when you're looking at disease or pest management, you really still always have to focus and on the cultural aspects. Make sure all of the cultural controls are in place. Fertility, water management, all of those really important things. If you don't get them right, there's no foundation or building block to move forward. You also have to get the mechanical and physical management of the crop right. And so therefore, combined with cultural, those two things are the most important. And if you don't get those right, you're either going to need a lot of the stuff above or you're not going to get the best results. So it's always important to focus on that. However, I think we all know there's circumstances when the weather conditions or the temperature goes beyond what we see as normal and provides that extra stress that means that we need some additional support. And I think in the past, we probably just had chemicals above those two lines. So we've done all our cultural control, we've done our mechanical control or physical control, and then what chemicals are we looking towards to maybe control some issues that have gone beyond our level of, you know, ability to cope. But that's changed a lot in the last 10 years. And really, you've had two additional building blocks that have gone in there, which I think are, you know, fantastic, really. They're definitely more digital modelling and monitoring. So much better understanding of moisture, temperature, humidity, loads of tools and diagnostics around monitoring to make sure that A, you understand what's going on, but B, then when you do have some interventions, you can do them at the best time and in a more preventative way. And also then, before we get to chemical, there's been a real, and especially in horticulture, there's been a real drive towards more biological control, and I think it's great. And so therefore, it really is then thinking about what biological controls can fit into this integrated management where chemicals, monitoring, and your cultural control fits. And then finally, I think when the pressure gets really, really high or you feel that you need some curative control, then definitely there's the chemical solution there that maybe gives you that extra level of protection. And I think it's quite difficult from a grower's point of view. You have to get everything right, or you have the cultural, mechanical, your modelling, your biological, the chemical, all of those things all have to be done correctly and at the right time. And it's a difficult process. But this is where I think Syngenta wants to be involved. We do a lot of digital work. We're driving forward our biological strategy and we offer really great chemical solutions. But we still also recommend that you do the bottom bits of the triangle first, and that's important, and then layer the other bits on. So why have we gone into biologicals? Well, we think it's important. We think it's really, really important to deliver good digital solutions, good biological solutions, and good chemical solutions as part of an integrated strategy to help the grower. It's what we're doing, and it's what we're doing today. So thanks everybody for turning up. Thanks everybody for listening to what we have to say about Taegro. And I hope you really enjoy Ant's presentation. If you've got any questions, come back to our website or come back to Fargro and please ask, and we'd be more than happy to help. Have a fantastic day. Thank you very much.
Thanks for that, Dan. A really nice intro to Syngenta and Taegro. So next up, we have Stuart Mills, who is the IPM specialist here at Fargro, and he's going to go into a bit more detail about the diseases that Taegro will control. Over to Stuart.
Hello, I'm Stuart Mills, an IPM specialist at Fargro Limited. In this video, we're just having a look at some of the important pathogens that Taegro provides suppression of, which includes botrytis, downy mildew, and powdery mildew. Taegro provides some important suppression of pathogens on crops such as cucurbits, solanaceae crops, lettuce and strawberry under protection, but also grapes outside. So, what is botrytis? It is a weak parasitic fungus that enters plant tissues through damaged or diseased material. Spores are airborne and easily spread by wind or air movement. The fungus, when it infects, produces a range of enzymes and toxins that cause degradation of cell walls and cell death. This allows the pathogen to feed. It causes soft rotting on the aerial parts of the plants. And worldwide, botrytis attacks over 200 crop hosts. Botrytis can produce tough resting spores to allow survival. It's called sclerotia. And it prefers humid conditions for spread and infection. So why is botrytis a problem? On strawberries, botrytis can cause loss of yield by infecting the flowers and either causing a rot of the flower directly or going dormant. The dormant pathogen resumes activity later on the berries, causing rot. Direct infection of berries or other damaged material can occur, leading to rotting too. On grapes, botrytis will cause loss of yield and quality as the infection causes rotting of grapes and the bunches, but infection also leads to changes in the grape's sugars and acids, thus reducing quality. Botrytis symptoms and damage caused. The most common symptom is the easy spotted masses of grey spores produced on dead material, which we can see on the picture on the right. Infection can run into stems and eventually causing death of the upper parts of the plant. Even if infection is not always successful, the fruit or flowers may show signs. This is called ghost spotting in some crops. Soft rots are often seen, especially in fruits. So what is powdery mildew? It is a fungal pathogen that attacks mainly the leaves, but can attack flowers, stems and fruit of some plants. A number of different species that often have a narrow host range. It affects many glasshouse and outdoor crops. It needs a host to complete its life cycle and to survive over winter. Uneven cultural and environmental conditions favour its spread and development. And it favours warm days and cool nights. And under these conditions, spore dispersal will be high. So why is powdery mildew a problem? On cucumber, courgette and summer squash, watermelon and melon, powdery mildew reduces photosynthesis, slows growth and reduces yield. On lettuce, there's a reduction in yield, but especially on quality. Tomato, aubergine, pepper and chilli, there's a reduction in yield and quality. Chilli plants can also drop their leaves too. On grapes, there's a reduction in yield due to lack of photosynthesis. Mildew can infect leaves, stems and fruit, leading to reduced yield and quality. So what symptoms and damage does powdery mildew cause? White fungal growth is usually seen on the upper surfaces of the leaf, as we can see in the photo on the left here. It may also be found on stems, fruit and flowers or under the leaves. And early signs may be yellow spots on the leaves. The last pathogen we're going to have a look at is downy mildew. So what is downy mildew? It is not a true fungus. It's actually more closely related to algae and also Pythium and Phytophthora and is an oomycete. It thrives in wet and damp conditions. Spores move in air currents and water splash, mostly. Moisture is needed on the leaf for spore germination and infection. And some species can be active from very low temperatures, 5 degrees in some examples. It can cause a systemic infection throughout the plant. Why is downy mildew a problem? On cucumber, courgette and summer squash, watermelon and melon, the pathogen causes reduction in vigour and yield, even though fruits are not directly infected. In lettuce, there is a reduction in quality. Downy mildew, symptoms and damage caused. Yellow angular areas may be seen on top of the leaf. These areas are most often limited by the veins. Eventually, these areas die and turn brown, and spores are produced underneath the leaf in the right conditions. Colour can vary from white through grey to brown and purple depending on the species. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions on Taegro or the diseases covered in this video, please contact Fargro for help and advice.
Thanks for that, Stuart. A really good overview of the key diseases that Taegro can control. So that just about sums it up for today's video. Please do join us next week, where it'll be myself going over the Taegro products in more detail. So looking at stuff like the mode of action, how it works, some technical details on the product. All that remains for me to do today is to thank our two speakers. So thanks Dan and Stuart for recording your videos. A really interesting insight into Syngenta, as well as a bit more detail on the key diseases we'll be looking at controlling next week with Taegro. If you're interested in any more information on Taegro or Syngenta or Fargro, please do visit the website or get in contact with us at the Fargro technical team. We have full technical notes on our products, so you can get more detail on the product Taegro itself. So yeah, please do get in contact, and thanks for your time.